long?
Short.
Short. Okay. Next. Applicability. So from which date it is applicable? You understand? Applicability means date of applicability. So I told you GST is applicable from 1st July 2017. So since which date this is applicable? Again MCQ. So this MCQ is not that hurts, huh? Because your institute is not going to ask you MCQs like in BCom it has happened. You already know the answers. Sometimes you don't understand the concept, but you know the answer. That will not happen at this level. This is CMA, this is CA. Different level altogether. Okay? So applicable. From this, which date this particular law became applicable? So 1st April 1962, not 61. Because income tax gets applicable in assessment year, not in previous year. There is a concept of assessment year and previous year. You earn in previous year and you pay tax in assessment year. Hello? There is a difference. I will teach you the difference. But write down this. So I taught you today one section at least. So your Sunday is not wasted, okay? One section you learn which may not come in exam. In MCQ it may come. Yeah, write down first, write down first. This diagram again belongs to indirect tax, huh? So detail again I will teach you, but in about India, more detail I will teach you in indirect tax. Whether you learn it in direct tax or indirect does not make any difference, ultimately you should know it. Now what is section 2? You already know. Section 2 of any act. Hello? Guess. Section 2 of any act. Not only income tax. You go, you open any act, section 2 will be same. What is there in section 2? Type. Definition. Yeah. Section 2 covers what? Definition. Now what is definition? What is definition? Definition means meaning assigned to certain terms which are meant for this act. So ordinarily you may have different meaning. So relative means you may have your own relatives ka list. Hello? But when we write relative in that particular section, then whatever is written in that section is relative for this act. Hello? So there are, because you know these words are having beautiful meanings. So plant. Plant can have two different meanings. Which two different meaning? If I say plant and machinery, then factory comes in your mind. If I say plant and trees, then that plant comes in your mind. You understand? So plant can, the word itself can have two different meaning. Hello? So which meaning we should pick up here? So that meanings are written in section 2. Section 2 defines terms which are used in act. Obviously, you cannot define terms at the end of the act. You need to define terms at the beginning of the act. Then only people will understand, okay, when I say person, person means this. So there is a definition of person. When I say income, okay, income means this. When I say AO, AO means four people. JC, ACDC and ITO. Hello? So when I use that term in future, you already know what does that mean. Okay? Therefore in section 2, they write definition. You open any act, section 2 is the definition. Okay? Definitions, there are two types of definitions, please understand. I will divide it for two types, positive and negative definitions. Okay, positive and negative definition. So how to identify positive and negative definition, please understand. So there is a definition of foreign company in income tax. We have definition of foreign company. Foreign company is a company other than domestic company. Foreign company is a company other than? Do you understand anything what is foreign company? No. To understand that, you must understand what is domestic company. You understand? So domestic company cannot be like domestic company is a company other than foreign company. Law cannot have two simultaneous negative definition. Hello. If one definition is negative, then the other one has to be positive. So we have half page definition of domestic company. So company incorporated in India, company which has made arrangement to distribute dividend in India is a domestic company. Something like this is written. If this is not a company, then your company is a foreign company. Same resident. Okay. You need to stay in India for 182 days to become resident. Conditions are there. Resident of India. Then who is non-resident? A person other than resident is a non-resident. So we define one term. Opposite to this will be written in negative language. Okay? That is positive and negative. Then we are having certain definition which are inclusive in form and certain are exhaustive, not exclusive. Exclusive part is also there, but we are having exhaustive. Inclusive and exhaustive. Inclusive definition will start with the word includes, whereas exhaustive definition will start with the word means. These two differences are very important, includes and means. I can explain you this only through practical examples. So you just write it down. This definition is more strict definition and this definition is the general definition. So income include these, that and something new also can be included in the income. But when I say relative means, only this is your relative. And the definition of relative when I teach you, cousin are not relative. Ordinarily cousins, ordinarily when you look at your cousin, what do you say? Relative, no?
Yes.
But according to income tax, cousin is not your relative because it is not written in that definition. So this is the impact of means definition and include definition. Some definition will start with the word includes, income includes, person includes, and some definition will start with the word assessment year means, per previous year means, assessee means. Which definition is more strict? Means, because that definition is exhaustive definition, and the definition we start with the includes word is inclusive definition, and in that definition it may have exclusion part also. So goods includes this and goods exclude this. So the definition can have an additional part which is exclusive part, but there cannot be exclusive definition. Definition can be either inclusive or exhaustive. Exclusive is a part of definition. Something they wanted to remove from the definition. Okay, that I will teach. Through practical only I can explain you this in detail. You just write it down, section 2. Then we are having section 3. And then we are having section 4. Okay. Now if you are a lawmaker, you assume that you are a lawmaker, which section you will try to write first? Section which is very much important or ordinary sections? Which section you will draft first? Obviously important. See, 1 and 2 is not your section. That is just the foundation for your sections to come. The next section has to be base section, important section. Alright. So section 3 was supposed to be the main section of the act. Hello, yes. Which is known as the charging section, which is known as the backbone. But section 3 is not a backbone, section 4 is the backbone. What I'm trying to tell you here is that there is something more important than backbone. Main section. Okay, what is the main section of income tax? 4. Section 4 is the charging section, basis of charge. What exactly this tax act will do? On what is taxable? Exactly what is taxable in income tax? So that is written in section 4. But there is something more important than section 4 which they define in section 3, because to understand section 4 you must understand section 3. Allow me to write section 4 in an ordinary way. Detail we will write because this is a chapter altogether. Section 4 is a chapter that I will teach you when I will start you with the syllabus. Section 4 is going to be a chapter. Okay. It is known as the basis of charge or charging section. Basis of charge. In bracket you write levy, we call it levy. Okay, I'm writing in very abbreviative manner. Okay, total income, please understand first, then write. And you have to write in a exactly same manner, because this is what we will learn later on. Total income, so tax is on which income? Total income. There is a definition of total income. Okay, earned by whom? Earned by person. Okay, now you will earn in a previous year, whereas you will pay tax in assessment year. Hello? Because I don't know income of 17-18. Do you know? No, sorry. I know income of 17-18, but I don't know income of 18-19 is going on. So when you pay tax in 18-19, you don't pay tax on 18-19 income, you actually pay tax on 17-18 income. So you stand in assessment year to pay tax in on previous year. You understand? Previous year means last financial year. Right now, which financial year is going on? 18-19. So what is the previous year for 18-19? But this is not your syllabus. You will write exam in which financial year? When you are writing exam, you will be standing in which financial year? June 19, no? June 19 comes in which financial year? 19-20. That is your assessment year. But when you are writing for 19-20, which financial year is concluded just now? 18-19. So what is your previous year? Previous year 18-19, and therefore you are doing assessment in 19-20. Hello? Alright? So total income earned by a person in previous year shall be assessed. Assess means compute. Okay? Computation of tax. And therefore those words are there. Assessee, assessing officer, assessment year. So assess is the base word. Assess means compute. In which year? Assessment year. Total income earned by a person in a previous year shall be assessed in assessment year at tax rates. Okay? Hello. Please understand, tax is a function of two things. Income multiplied by tax rate. Now, income multiplied, if I say 30%, 30% you will apply on what? Income. Then only you will get tax amount. So tax is a function of two things, income and tax rate. Income, this act will teach you how to compute. Tax rate. Now GST rates are given in GST.